that shopping trolley full of food, it's pretty damning when you see how much food there is there. Why is there such a big increased need?
Well, it's a hugely increased need because that shopping trolley is all donated. But then on top of that shopping trolley, the families get, we've been giving out $300 vouchers to the supermarket, and we've also been giving out kilo blocks of mince to go with that. And we've used up our 6 months of our budget and money towards helping families already in the first 6 weeks of this year. And I think that's just pointing to the fact that things are tough out there. Rentals have gone up. People are being stuck at home because of various reasons, COVID and others. Jobs have disappeared in Whangarei and to a degree. And I think with petrol and all the rest of it, it's just tough out there. It's tough for the bottom income, it's tough for the middle income. And by the way, that shopping basket is all donated, and I want to put a plug in here. If it wasn't for people like Kids Can, Frontera, the Hapori Committee, Sanitarium itself, and Breakfasts in Schools, we would not be able to help people as much as we are, and it's appreciated.
How big is the increase in need this year compared to last year?
Well, last year we spent $12,000 of our own money on the meat and the shopping vouchers, because remember, the groceries you saw are donated. So far this year we're up to $6,000, and we're 6 weeks in. And it's not that we're giving out holus bolus. We give out these when we hear through the grapevine that some of our families are struggling, or the child might happen to say, we didn't have any breakfast, or we didn't have something else, you know, we didn't have any tea last night. And also, you've got to remember, we're doing lunches for kids here. Every kid gets lunch and all the rest of it. So these hard times, are on top of the lunch scheme. And, you know, that's where some of your taxes go.
In your time in teaching, have you seen it this tough?
I don't think I have. I've seen individual families having really tough times, but I don't think I've seen the large number of families. Look, last week we gave out one of those baskets plus the vouchers to a mum who was in a motel, emergency housing, and there were two other families in there, and she said to me, do you mind if I share this with the other two families? And that really broke my heart, because here was a mum from our school who had real need for all that, and yet she was thinking of the other two families that weren't from our school, that had nothing. And that's, I think, what it's come down to.
What do you think the government can and should do to address this?
Yeah, the government is caught to a degree, and I understand that, but I think that they need to possibly look at the bottom end and how they are really hurting. I think they possibly need to look at the petrol taxes initially, just for a period of time, but they're in a real hard spot, and we've seen this with the government before when overseas conditions take over. But there is no doubt they've got to do something. And I would rather that they borrowed to see people who weren't starving and in this situation than actually what some other people are advocating.
Seeing the increase in need, how does it affect you emotionally?
It's the futility. Because these families that are needing this help aren't just lined up there like they're painted as if they're no hopers. These are families that care. These are families that want to do their best for these kids. And it's the futility that there's nothing else I can do or the school can do but to make sure the kids are fed at school and to give away some food for them to have at home. And it's the futility, because it's other things that need done that we cannot affect, and they're government things.